Breaking news. We are getting reports of a shooting at a college this morning.
Oh my God.
At least 3 faculty members are among the 17 known dead.
Hi, Sammy, it's Mom. Call me back as soon as you can, all right? Love you.
The campus is completely locked down. There's nothing we can do there.
Just wait?
I'm sure it's fine.
What's incredible, the script that was written and how Sean directed this, is that the movie isn't about this kid or the killing. It's a love story, really, about this couple that's, you know, they're really disparate, they're falling apart, they don't know each other anymore. I think that happens a lot in long-term relationships where you forget who the person is and you start lying to yourself and to the other person about who you are to make them feel more comfortable or safer. And suddenly this event happens and there's nowhere to hide. And the safety is all gone and they have to be bare bones and reveal themselves to each other. And I think that brings them together again.
One of the things I found interesting about the film was that it's not about a couple who seem all happy at the beginning and then, you know, tragedy strikes. It's about a couple who are already feel like they've gone as far as they can go, and then this event happens and it forces them to stay together in a way because of what's going on. But it also brings up all the unspoken things. They're a couple who are not really talking about things. They're not communicating very well, and there's so much under the surface buried that eventually, because of what happens, comes out, and that somehow becomes the catalyst for them to eventually find each other again.
So what do you want to do now?
Let's play cards.
I thought you said one was missing.
5-card draw. Nothing's wild.
Right, and what are we betting? What are we, 16 again?
A week before we started shooting, the mother of the Columbine shooter came out in Oprah magazine with her first interview ever in a decade. It was stunning, and she talked about her grief process and the blame of herself and how she didn't know. So it was really relevant and really affected me. Every little thing that I say to my son, you know, if I raise my voice to him, I think, oh my God, he's gonna be in therapy for the rest of his life. I'm a terrible mother. I mean, we just, as parents, I don't know anyone who doesn't go there. And when something this tragic happens, of course you would blame yourself.
I mean, how could he do it?
I gave him everything he could want.
But he was such a quiet kid. He was lonely. He never played with the neighbor kids. We should have known that they were.
Why does it have to be our fault?
Well, I think they're both looking for answers, you know. I think it's very frightening, the idea that something can happen randomly, you know, even though for them there's a kind of a relief in feeling like it's not their fault because they don't have to take responsibility for this awful thing that's happened. There's almost, on a more fundamental level, it's more frightening to think that life is just chaos, that there is no, you know, anything like that can happen at any time and that you have no part to play in it somehow.
We did it. We messed him up. Maybe we didn't give him any hope, or we didn't exactly show him how to be happy.
How can you say that?
He wasn't well. He was depressed and irrational and angry.
Well, everyone gets depressed and angry, but that's still no explanation. We don't know why he did what he did.
It was an incredible creative experience. Literally, we did this movie for free. We basically had to pay them. Most of our crew did it for free. We shot it in downtown LA in 12 days or whatever it was, and just enjoyed every bit of the creative process.
Some things are better left.
Did we do something?
Forgot.
Did we not do something?
Should take a few more weeks off. See somebody.
I don't need to see anyone.
Bill, it's not a suggestion.
So we're just gonna erase our son's memory, is that it?
We have to try to start moving forward.
You should be defending
Heather! There is no defense for what he did!